Yo, what's happening, world? Name's Raheem Flowers, and I just got out the shower. I got this towel on my head, looking like a Palestine rebel. R.I.P. Yasser Arafat. Nah, I'm fucking around. But, you know, I've been pondering on this for like the last 2 days. And, probably like the last couple days, maybe 4 or 5 days now. But I've come to realize how much motherfuckers really lack self-awareness. I think I'm gonna make this the epilogue of my video series, Confession of a Black Man. I think this is gonna be the epilogue to it. I've come to realize that you have a lot of cats out there who will tell you and remind you of what everybody else is doing wrong, and only in the heat of the moment, when they really acted on a blunder that is affecting their livelihood, will they reluctantly own up to what they do. They don't have the mental and the spiritual aptitude nor fortitude to really tap into that. And that's a form of power. I was watching both Myron and Abba chew at each other like termites. And it made me think to myself, when motherfuckers do all these exposed videos and these reaction videos, it really shows me how much they're doing their very best to do this little tit-for-tat and point out each other's hypocrisy, and not even realizing that you're just trying to deflect or steer away, rather, who you are as a person, instead of who you're trying to portray yourself to be. Although I think Abba is the person who lacks self-awareness in this context more. To me, you can't be somebody who prides themselves on ethics and morality and getting on people for doing things that are scummish and need to be held accountable. But if there are videos out there of you clowning motherfuckers for being on some suspect homosexual behavior, but there's a video out there, and I even put this on one of my older videos when I was going in on the rest of the Red Spill community about getting milked like a cow, and then you had Preach talking about some how to in the doggy style. That's exactly why I had to get that Sean Kingston Batsy Boy, because that is indeed Batiman sodomite action, or as haram as they say in Islam, because like me and like Amudu Myron, you grew up in a Muslim background, you had a Muslim father, so yeah, like me, I'm gonna use myself for an example. I know what led to my channel being demonetized. All this shit I said about Jews, the things that I said about black women and single mothers back in 2016, the way that I used to talk so abrasively, I'm aware of my shortcomings when it comes to my own living situation, living in my brother's condo. Could have had my own crib years ago, but what did I do? I took a chance and I took a risk trying to invest in myself and my own future and freedom and independence. And at that cost, I ended up fucking up the quality of my own life, or at least for the time being, I definitely put myself in harm's way. I also realized that it affected how my dynamics with whatever connection I built with women. I also realized how much that I ended up severing ties with my own siblings. I also realized that even me being careless, even recently, even when I had a discussion with a woman who I built a strong connection with, and I told her that I wasn't monogamous, but guess what I did? I did something that was careless as fuck. Pocket dialed and was messing around with another girl when I was around the science and industry, for those who know about Chicago. I was messing around, kissing on her, complimenting her kisses, caressing her, and I had her on FaceTime. This happened to me on Monday, Memorial Day. So that's embarrassing as fuck for both of us, but more so her. I'm aware of all these things. I know my shortcomings and I know my fuck ups. That's why I made that series, Confession of a Black Man. And there's not too many, I don't know anybody, honestly, any content creators who has been on some real transparent stuff that you probably should not even be telling the internet, because you know that we live in a cybernetic Babylon. Side note, because I thought about something. You want to know what ABBA and Owen Benjamin got in common? The fact that they both like getting pegged anally, and they use comedy to hide behind the debauchery that they enact on, whether it's accusations, hit pieces, misconstruing. Him and Owen Benjamin used that form of comedy to hide behind whatever agendas they got. Plus, they like getting the salad tossed. So that's what Owen Benjamin and Alba have in common. It's crazy to me how you have so many people who speak on this moral, high moral ground, and they'll just tell you about what everybody else is doing wrong, how hurtful they are to communities, how poisonous and detrimental they are, but they never look in the dirty mirror that they got to tell you where they fuck up. I also found something else interesting. Because when it comes to self-awareness, not only do you need fortitude and aptitude, you also need to understand context, especially historical context. You see, when I look at Black people who speak about slavery, you gotta understand that the pale-skinned people would have never known slavery. They wouldn't have a blueprint. They wouldn't have a schematic. They wouldn't have a foundation to go off of if it wasn't for slavery that went on in Africa. Slavery regarding white slave trades and the Barbary slave trade that many of those Moorish brothers enacted on. So, for all you Pan-Africans out there, let me tell you this. And I don't even got any problem with Pan-African brothers, man. Shout out to Nefakari Desalini. I ain't got no problem with Pan-Africans, but hell, I grew up in a Pan-African home my damn self. But objectively speaking, for all you Pan-African cats out there, understand that there's even an African proverb that tells you that we couldn't have had, and I'm paraphrasing, we couldn't have had problems outside if there weren't problems from within. So the warfares, all that tribalism that went on, yeah, all that internal conflict, yeah, and guess what? The pale-skinned people exploited the fuck out of that. These were the same people that were civilized by the Moors, especially throughout Spain, Italy. Civilized by the Moors, right? These are the people who were in the what they call the Dark Ages in Europe. Couldn't make a damn thing. Probably couldn't even have a hard-boiled egg properly without shitting on themselves and shitting bricks and getting diarrhea. Remember, the more civilized Spain. And now what do? They clown the fuck out of. In Spain, the Spaniards clown the fuck out of the Moors. You see, everything is a vicious cycle. That's what it is, a typhoon. It's just white people's turn. There was a point in time when white people smelled like shit and just dynamically, they weren't shit. And now people are saying it's a white man's world. White supremacy. And then let's go talk about the 1948ers. The Jews were getting expelled for generations. And then they figured out a way to pull their wealth together. And how is it that they're less than 5% of the planet, and yet they have so much equity? Because they figured out and they value. They understood the value behind being financiers and being bankers, because that was not, there wasn't that many viable options for them to take. Getting kicked the fuck out. And guess what? Now everybody's blaming, everybody's saying, hey man, you got people making memes about Jewish people being money grubbers and being greedy and all that stuff. But hey, I mean, I know there's multi-layers behind that one, but this is the box that many of the pale-skinned Europeans have largely contributed to building. So yeah, there's that. And then the feminists. All these men out here, especially in the red spill, the red pill community, talking about how fucked up feminism are. Hypocritically enough, you're just an inverted feminist. And guess what? They wouldn't have even gotten to the position they got to without being backed by men. Talk about benevolent sexism, ladies. So, that's also something I'd like to point out. So when I look at all this back and forth, just understand that it's not that they run shit. It's not that these are prevalent factors. It's just their turn. And then it's going to go back to how it was before. And then it's going to go back to how it is now. The circle of life, and it woos us all. Because it does. I mean, then again, Disney, Walt Disney, was a 33-degree Mason. So, he knows something that the average person doesn't know. That's why a lot of the Masons do things in secrecy, hide information from the world. All things you gotta take notes of. That's all I'm gonna say for now. Peace out.